So now first and 10.
Okay, what is up, everybody? It's your boy, Mr. Man K Gamer, back again. This right here is another AFC divisional round matchup. The Kansas City Chiefs coming off that week one bye going against the Houston Texans right now. Before I get into the Texans, let me say something. I know the obvious pick is the Chiefs. You can't really go wrong picking the Chiefs. Patrick Mahomes, Tyreek Hill, Watkins. Oh man, that beautiful offense and everything like that. And that defense who's came to his own. But anyway, I'm going to not put my focus on the Chiefs right now. And I'm going to actually go with the upset pick. Now, the reason why I call this an upset pick is for the simple fact that watching this simulation here, it kind of just made me think about this one team back in 2012. Their best player happens to tear his tricep muscle out for damn near half the season, but come back on the playoffs. It happened to win the Super Bowl. That is my 2012 Baltimore Ravens. Ray Lewis tore his tricep, was gone for 7 weeks. The Ravens still do just enough to get into the playoffs. Ray Lewis leading that defense, they win the whole Super Bowl. And this reminds me of a mirror image. The Texans remind me of the 2012 Ravens because the team has been playing great. They won their division, but their best player, their best star player, if you ask me, J.J. Watt was injured most of the season. They know he comes back, and what do? They rally against the Buffalo Bills. For me, I had the Texans winning that game anyway because the Buffalo Bills offense, I knew, could not do anything pretty much to go against the Texans. And I, Watson, Hopkins, shit like that, I knew that was going to be a dynamic duel. And that's what it reminds me of. It reminds me of J.J. Watt, like Ray Lewis, coming back in the playoff to help this team go far in the playoff. And that's the main X factor that I see. J.J. Watt coming out there. Even though Deshaun Watson got sacked about six times. Now, if he gets sacked six times, he gets again his shitty Chiefs and have horrible field position. You know the Chiefs are going to win that game. I don't think the Chiefs are good enough to get about six sacks. We know the Buffalo Bills have a better front four. So, but if the Texans can come out there and play like I think they could play, they could win this game and get an upset. And watching this simulation went down to two overtimes, pretty cool, and I sit there and watch it. But the more and more I watch the overtime, the more and more, it's kind of just to say, who do you trust? A team that's been playing for the past couple weeks or a team that's coming off a bye with a little rust? So that's why I think both mental plays key. J.J. Watt is back, their defensive leader's back, and then Merciless making all those fucking fumble recoveries. Shit, that defense plays so good, even though it was against the Buffalo Bills offense, and we know the Kansas City Chiefs offense is probably like top three most explosive offense in the league. I love defense better than defense. So I think if that defense getting their leader back, J.J. Watt is going to be the X factor in this game. They want to have something for Patrick Mahomes. They want to contain him. They want to do what they can to probably. So I think Tyreek Hill will still want to do his thing. But at the end, just like last week against the Bills, the Texans found a way to find Hopkins when it mattered in the second half of the game for them to get that W. That's what I think. Sean Watson and DeAndre Hopkins are going to find a way to win this game, but it's going to come for that defense and that leadership of J.J. Watt getting it done, just like Ray Lewis did in 2012. Anyway, it's your boy, Mr. Man, the Chiefs and Texans. I'm going for the upset because even though the Chiefs are a great team, I honestly have not. I'm not a Chiefs fan. Unless you're a diehard Kansas City person, you know Patrick Mahomes is great. I'm not going to jump ship, really. I just want to. This game is very good for me. No, never really cared for the Texans when they came, and I never really cared about the Chiefs in like forever. But anyway, this right here, I'm just going to go for upset pick. I'm going to go with the Texans pulling off this win. Got a lot of momentum. They got the leader back. Their offense, this is explosive. That's the Kansas City. Now, Kansas City defense got to find a way to step up, but I don't think that's, I think that's highly unlikely. So anyway, I'm going with the Texans over Chiefs.
A partner, a great game that we got to see and making it extra special. Not only did I get four quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later.
You really just wanted four quarters, what you wanted. But how much fun was that? We had that type of a game where we got us to overtime, and then we get the dramatic ending to finish things off as well. What a game.